U.S. scientists may have found a way to produce clean energy by way of dirty water. This is according to a new study that's out on Monday. And the way it works is that there's a prototype about the size of a D-cell battery. And it consists of two electrodes, one positive, one negative. And when you put it into a bottle of wastewater filled with bacteria, as the bacteria consumes the organic material, the microbes cluster around the negative electrode, throwing off electrons, which are captured in turn by the positive electrode. So that's just a very long-winded way of saying we can turn shit water into an energy source. Now, it sounds disgusting, but it's also very good. Because guess what? We're never going to run out of shit water as long as human beings are alive. Not going to run out of that. Now, they actually call the process fishing for electrons. And scientists knew for a long time that this idea could be done in theory, but they haven't found a way to do it relatively efficiently until now. In other words, all other attempts wouldn't get enough energy to actually justify trying to do this. Now they can harness enough energy, about 30% of the potential energy in wastewater they can harness. That's about the same rate as commercially available solar panels. And they say that the process has another added benefit. It cleans the water. So you know how, you know, now if you were to go to the bathroom and then flush the toilet, it goes to the waste treatment plant, and they have their ways of doing it now, but this is a whole another way to do it. And it's a somewhat efficient way of doing it, and it could cut down a lot of money in that respect, and it could also create energy for us. So this is such a clear example, yet again, of where, now, to be fair, I'm not saying that they should have known this already because the information just came out, right? But the federal government should look at this and say, we should invest billions of dollars into this and do it in small towns all across America and eventually try to spread it throughout the power grid. Look, we have the technology, we have the capability to actually move over to a green economy. Between solar power and wind power, and now this wastewater power, essentially, is I guess what we'll call it, right? Between thorium, which is technically nuclear power, but thorium is considered meltdown proof. I mean, there's no better source for energy. Look, nuclear energy, the only downside of it is that sometimes you have nuclear fucking meltdowns and Chernobyl happens, right? But if you can assure that no meltdown ever happens, then of course you should go ahead and exhaust that method. What are you insane? That's like the perfect way to get energy, right? And we have that. It's thorium, but you gotta invest in it because it's so crushed right now. The industry is so crushed right now because they don't have anybody investing in it. The governments are like, maybe we'll do it. And you have the oil companies with a stranglehold on the government, which holds them back from investing in these things. And look, I have even more news. Also, in a separate story, but somewhat related, nitrous oxide, which is largely from livestock production, makes up 38% of agriculture emissions. And it accounts for about one-third of all greenhouse gases, and it has a more powerful warming effect than carbon dioxide or methane. And scientists just discovered that a certain type of grass, called brachiara grasses, they inhibit the release of nitrous oxide. So guess what? We found another way to curtail global warming as time goes by. So if we were to just plant more of this type of grass in the climates that can support it, you would automatically be reducing carbon emissions or emissions, greenhouse gas emissions. And if we can genetically modify it to be used in any climate, which is what scientists are working on now, it's another huge breakthrough. Look, the bottom line that I'm trying to get to is we have the science going in the right direction. And this is with limited means, limited resources, because we have the sequester in the United States, which hurts research in the United States, right? We need to fully fund these things and then fully fund the solutions if we want to be rational people. But of course, the reality is that our politicians are corrupt and they're bought by the oil companies and the fossil fuel industry. So they kind of sit idly by while we have all the answers waiting to really make a dent in global warming, but we don't do it.